I'm glad that you're here to remember my mom, Tillie Garner. Hopefully the words that I can bring you today will elicit a small memory of her as I speak. So this is a story about my mom, Tillie Garner, who passed away February 1st, 2019, just 2 days short of her 95th birthday. Both Dad and I were present at her passing. This story is about Tim's and my memories of her life. I've tried to only remember the happy times. There were times of hardship and disappointment, but at the end, they really don't matter. And I can't remember too many of those times. It is my opinion that my mom would have had a pretty good life overall, even though at the end, it was not so good when she was institutionalized. One of my first memories is lying behind and under the wood stove. Tim was a baby. I and the cat and the dog were all curled up behind and under the wood burning stove. I remember it as a spot of warmth and comfort, warmth and safety. We lived in the old house, the kitchen in the front, the living room to the north at the back, with an old stove and paisley wallpaper in the living room. Mom and Tim, there was also stairs that went up to the upstairs, the two bedrooms upstairs. Mom and Tim were in the front bedroom, and me, Dad, and the bees were in the back bedroom. I remember a thick, warm down quilt, and I remember chamber pots. I remember an outdoor toilet, I remember 40 below zero, frozen laundry on the clotheslines, not much like different weather than we have right now. That was what I remember, and we thought we were living in a lap of luxury. What were the memories of my mom and dad before this? How things have changed. In mom and dad's time, and even in our times, we have gone from the simplicity of everyday life and basic survival to being absorbed by the complexity of technology. Where's my cell phone? My mom brings back the memories of simple, easier times. And I associate my mom with security, comforts, happiness reflected in those times. A mom is predeceased by her parents and siblings, with the exception of Uncle Carl, who's here today. Her father, John Wetlaufer, married Stevens, and they conceived Aunt Em and Aunt Helen. Mrs. Stevens died in February 1910, and Wetlaufer remarried the widow, Elizabeth Schmidt, named Matthews, in June 1921. And she had three sons, Warner, Henry, and Bill. In the new marriage, they conceived Johnny, my mom, Tillie, Carl, and Ruth, all born in the old farmhouse. Tragedy struck twice in 1935. In May, Mom's mom, Elizabeth, passed away from pneumonia. And then, on December 22nd, a hunting accident killed Johnny and took brother Bill's hand off. Mom was 11. As might be expected, these tragic events seemed to create a massive chasm in the family. And to the day Mom passed, she bore unhappy memories about those times and how she had to grow up and take responsibility before her time. Unbeknownst to me, a song that Wetlaufer sang to console Carl, Ruth, and Mom was "I've Got Rings on My Fingers." And unfortunately, I wanted to play it today, but I couldn't make it happen. Downstairs, maybe. Mom remembered those times of her youth as a time of horse and buggy, milking, cows, killing chickens, churning butter, stooking grain, large work crews, and the parents leaving on Saturday daybreak to the Edmonton market. And Mom remembers her first car in 1928. Family life revolved around this church, Peace Lutheran Church. Mom attended grade school at St. John's, which was one mile east of where the farm is right now. And then high school in a two-room schoolhouse in Spruce Grove in the vicinity of where Harvey's is right now. Mom's dad died in 1945, and Mom was tasked by her dad with looking after her younger siblings, Carl and Ruth. However, being a typical young person, the allure of finding independence and a job and getting away from the farm was appealing. Mom initially had a job at Needham's General Store in Spruce Grove, and then moved to Edmonton to live with Jean Berry and work at Woodbridge. Carl remembers going to visit Mom in Edmonton. Dad remembers meeting Mom in the fall of 1945. Apparently, Mom was working at Needham's General Store at the time. Dad, John Hillier, Horace Hillier, were on their way to a dance at Kelly's Hall in Stony Plain. They stopped at the store. While John went in, Dad and Horace stayed in the car. Dad heard Mom tell John to bring the car around and don't race them over. And somehow this impressed Dad. Then Mom invited John, Horace, and Dad to stop at the farm for coffee on their way home. And that is when Bill met Till for the first time. Bill and Till met again at subsequent parties, and it led to them dating. After dating for 5 years, Bill and Till got married on June 30th, 1950. The wedding was at Grace Lutheran Church, and Mom's brother, Warner, put on the reception at the farm north of Spruce Grove. Jonathan, or me, was born September 19th during a snowstorm and in 1951, and Tim was born June 17th, 1955. Mom and Dad were living at the farm. Carl describes those times with Bill and Till having lots of friends. There were people visiting the farm every day. It was not uncommon to feed 15 to 20 people. Nobody had any money. And a case of beer would satisfy 20 people. The friends would help with the chores, cooking, harvesting, and there was always time for socializing and playing cards. On reflection, it seems like idyllic, simple times. Mom was the homemaker, but Mom did lots of work on the farm. She was quite at home on the tractor. In the days when you mowed hay, when hay was dry, she would rake the hay into swaths so Bill could bale it when he got home. Also in the fall, she would start the combine and fill the truck with grain and then, so that it could be unloaded when Bill got home from work. On reflection, Mom had a sense of independence. Dad had a job at Chevron that paid the bills, but the farm always provided the supplemental income, and from that supplemental income, we had groceries and treats. Over the course of time, that supplemental income came from various sources for making it happen. My first memory is livestock. Pigs, lambs, chickens, cattle. I do remember having a baby lamb who had lost his mother. And so that lamb was my playmate in the house. Fun for me, but it was fun for Mom as well. Commercially, my first memory is separating cream, and Mom was in charge of that. We had a fancy automatic separator, and the cream went into the cream cans. We took it into town at the old 56 Ford Park. I also remember making butter and ice cream once in a while. My second memory is chickens. We always had 200 chickens to lay eggs, gathering eggs, cleaning eggs, and selling eggs. It's to work on a weekly basis, but I also remember delivering eggs to Good Sam and various other friends and institutions with Mom. I remember delivering with Mom. These eggs provided Mom with cash to buy groceries, but to also give Tim and me small amounts of money to take to school so that we could buy treats like chocolate milk. Then there were more chickens and turkeys. Those were for eating, 1,000 chickens. When these chickens were to full size, usually 7 to 10 pounds, it came time to kill, clean, and eat, sell them. You could buy your chickens for a very good price, but you had to participate in the killing, plucking, and eviscerating. And I think it was as much a social event as a way to make money. And of course, after you were done with the work, you had to go into the house and have coffee, tea, crackers, cheese, cookies, and cakes. There was always something to eat. Mom loved to cook. Rice rolls were her specialty. And who can't remember Till's dills? They were the best. The food was spectacular. Mom knew that she was a good cook, and to show your appreciation, all you had to do was eat. Refusing to eat was not an option. And for not too surprising that she would start a catering company, TG Industries. As with the commercial commerce generated by eggs and chickens, The catering business gave Mom a sense of independent income and a source of independent revenue that was not tied to Dad. She offered three meats and rice rolls in her menu for a price that was affordable for her patrons. She was in high demand. She loved cooking for people, and she had a crew of women who were her friends. Again, it was a social event, and they got together to make rice rolls, peel potatoes, cook food, and then, of course, there was the main event at the night of the catering. There was stress. Would there be enough food? But there was always enough food, and the cooking crew benefited from many delicious leftovers. Mom had great pride in her cooking achievements. And this business venture, PG Industries, with her catering, was probably some of the happier times in her life. She just loved that. So, what are some of my other things that I remember? Well, I remember the girl. Mom and Dad went out for various occasions, and in that day, it was important that a woman have a very specific shapeliness that was offered to Mom only by a girl, and she didn't love to eat. I remember whisk drives every second Saturday night at the Winterburn Hall over the winter months. I remember the cowbell. She would open the window on the east side of the house and ring that cowbell when supper was ready or dinner was ready or she wanted something. I remember the 410 shotgun. Again, because of her need to be her own person, it was important she had a gun that she could handle. I don't know if she ever shot the gun, not even at the Magpies. I remember her driving the old 56 Ford, driving the various vehicles, driving the grain trucks, driving the combine. It was Mom who taught Dad to drive. Mom was a good driver. I remember going to Edmonton IGA in the West End for groceries. I remember going for Chinese food, the Purple Lantern downtown Edmonton. I remember Mom sneaking us money. Don't tell your dad. I remember playing cards. Mom always loved to play cards, and she taught Tim and me how to play various card games. But the deal was, we had to get the work quickly done so we could have time to play cards. And on reflection, I'm not exactly sure that this was not a strategy to get the work done. I remember harvesting. Mom helped Dad with everything, and she cooked spectacular meals, hauled grain, drove the combine. I remember potatoes and the garden. Potatoes were a constant point of stress in Mom's life. First to plant them in the spring, then to harvest them in the fall. And in the fall, I would haul 30 plus bags of potatoes into the basement. And then in the spring, I would haul 25 plus bags of potatoes out of the basement. And in some ways, these potatoes represented a form of security for Mom. She loved potatoes. But more than that, when there was enough potatoes, she knew that no matter what else might happen in the world, she would have the certainty of nutritious food. I remember Mom witching water. Mom had the ability to use an old gold watch on a string and find water. She found all the water on our farm, and she helped other people find their wells as well. I remember my coming of age. As you know, I was always a big, strong, fairly strong boy in my youth. So somehow on this occasion, I had bounced off, and I had incurred Mom's wrath. To the point where she took a broom and beat me with it. Well, she was obviously trying to make an impression on me. She hit me with the broom in the broom room. She stepped back and she didn't know what to do. And I think I laughed at the situation, which made the matter worse. And this was kind of a turning point. I remember gambling. I know Mom enjoyed her various trips to Las Vegas and Reno, and she loved to play the slot machines. She knew she was going to win, and overall she did win. And lastly, I remember celebrating several anniversaries. Tim and I were fortunate to hold several anniversaries and birthday parties for both Mom and Dad. Mom was a general. She commanded respect. When catering or working in the garden or filling chickens, she gave direction. Get it done, do it right. She was the boss, and you could just ask the caterer. I would not categorize Mom as a sickly person, but she did have a sort of health problems. When it came to health, she was not lucky and had issues with arthritis and bad knees. She had numerous operations on her knees, and both were replaced. And she seemed to always contract a local bug or virus that was going around, and migraine headaches were a problem. Like any mother, Mom was ferociously proud of her boys, Tim and me. She would have done anything to defend us. We could really do nothing wrong. She would have gone to the end of the world and back for us. And she had this loyalty and love to her very end. So this is Tim and how Tim and I remember my mom. Love is a tough emotion for the Garner family, including my dad. And the Garner men have a tough time expressing their emotions. But yes, indeed, we loved our mom, and so did many of you. Thank you.
Add to John's eulogy, I have here 12 things about Mom that maybe most of you don't know. Mom loved to read. Evening Journal, Time Magazine, Reader's Digest, Life Magazine in the 60s, Hello Canada, Outdoor Canada, Bird and Blooms, and many more. So we have quite a few periodicals at home. And then, when it came to watching TV with Wheel of Fortune and Jeopardy, she would get as many answers as anybody because she was so well read. She loved jewelry, especially diamonds. And so when she catered, and if she made a little bit of money, she would buy herself some diamond rings or other diamond jewelry. She loved flowers, either picked or bought. And Dad made sure in this last year that Mom had flowers in her room all the time. And so that was nice. She loved Chinese food. That was kind of our go-to meal when we went out. And it could not have any MSG as Mom would get headaches from the Chinese food. Mom wasn't a drinker, but interestingly, in the last 5 years, she would like to have a quarter bottle of beer. And so she would drink this honey ale, and she'd put a cork in it. So she'd get the beer, open it up, have two swigs, put the cork in, say, take it back to the fridge next night. So a bottle of beer lasted a week. I don't know how freezing it was by the end. She loved cats. She missed the cats. Dad has a couple cats right now, and she would always ask her how the cats were doing. She drove fast. She had a heavy foot. No question. I don't know how many speed tickets she got, but she just ignored speed limits. She was a curler for many years in the women's league in Spruce Grove here, so she did a little bit of curling. She loved Western movies. Dad and Mom in the evenings now very rarely watch TV except Jeopardy and Wheel of Fortune, and then they would watch Westerns. And so they have thousands of Western movies, and Mom really enjoyed watching them. And once you watch them after a couple years, you can watch them again. I can too. By the way, John, did you call me fat? I kind of got that impression. She loved playing solitaire and card games, especially 31. We've had great times with quarters and losing money. And the last thing is, John said I was her favorite. I was the youngest. Maybe that's one of the reasons. And help Mom with housekeeping and cleaning. John, because he was older, was outside helping Dad do the chores. And so I was inside cooking and helping with cleaning. However, John has learned to play the ukulele in the last 3 or 4 years. And in this last couple months, he would go in and play the ukulele for Mom. And she really enjoyed it. You know, she's kind of out of it, but when she heard that ukulele, she had a smile on her face. So, John, I think you crawled your way back up to normal. So, those are some of my memories of Mom, and thank you for coming.
Today, our hearts go out to Garner's family at their loss, and especially a longtime spouse, Bill, and their sons, John and Tim, and their wives, Karen and Jane, and her grandchildren.
Memories. pass between the pages of my mind. Memories sweeten through the ages just like wine.
There